Hello, this is Cristi. In this short video, I will show you how you can add markers in Descript Storyboard. There has been a change in version 74, 75, and now markers are a little bit harder to make, but not still impossible to make, and I will show you how to do it. There are multiple ways to add markers in a script. So I have a video here, which you don't have to have a video. It can work on audio as well. And you can see these things, markers in here. They are like larger text, they are bold, and you can see them on the side here. This is called a scene rail or whatever this is called. This is where the markers show up. And if you click on it, it jumps to that particular marker and it is a nice navigation through your project. And I use markers to mark up different sections or changes of topics in my compositions. So in the latest versions, this has been changed, the way that you add markers. You used to be able to add markers with the M shortcut, which you still can do, but it's a catch in there. You have to be careful. If I am inside of a text here and I put a new line in now, and I press M for a marker, it doesn't work because Descript has now modified it so that if you are on a blank line, you have this tool here, this toolbar that shows up where it says start writing, and it automatically activates write mode. So the letter M might be a letter you want to type, or any other letter will activate the write mode, and you see it's going with that blue outline around your transcript. That doesn't work anymore to add markers. If you are on a new line and you want to insert a marker, you have to press the hashtag key, which is shift and 3 on my keyboard. And there you go. It inserts a new marker. It's pre-selected and you can type, this is a new marker. So I have inserted a new marker, hashtag key. Now, there is still a way to add markers with the M key, but you have to not be on a blank line. So if I delete that blank line and I go somewhere in my text, maybe at the end of this text, I am not in write mode, I can now press M and it still adds a marker. But I have to be on a line with text on it. I cannot be on a blank line. A blank line always activates write mode when you type any letter or number. Another way to add markers is really using the insert toolbar, the new insert toolbar. So if I delete this and I press a new line, I can go to these three dots in here and I can add marker right there. It's a little unintuitive because it's on the opposite side of where you would expect it to be. It's not on the left, it's on the far right of this menu. But again, if I click add marker, it inserts a marker. I would have liked to have it in this new menu that they included in here on the left sidebar with the plus. Click plus and you should have marker in here. Well, you don't. So I don't know, maybe they're going to add that back or whatever. This new toolbar here has a bunch of stuff that I never look at because it's very complex and it's got a lot of stuff. I like to rely on keyboard shortcuts a lot. There is one thing that's disappeared completely so far. I can't find it anymore. There used to be an icon on the top right side of the screen. So if I increase the size of this, it used to be right here at the top and you could have, it was like a little icon with some bullet points on it. Those were the markers. So that was helping a lot with navigation in the markers, especially if you are in a composition that is audio only. If I go to this composition and I turn it to audio only, from the file menu, set composition to audio only. Now the markers are gone. These are my compositions here. So look, I have no markers now. I have them still in text and I can still add them, but it's very difficult to now navigate to the markers. Well, there is one thing that they've added. There is this new actions, little search bar, toolbar, conductor thing. I don't know what it's called. It uses the conductor shortcut, shift command K, and you can add new stuff in here or do stuff and search for stuff and insert new things. And you have jump too. But look at this. How many clicks do I have to do to go to a specific marker? I have to click on this bar, jump to, jump to marker, and then there's my markers. And I really don't see why it was necessary to remove that little navigation toolbar, especially when you are in an audio-only composition. So there you have it, how to add markers. You can press M if you are in text somewhere. You can press Shift and #3 or hashtag key if you are in a new line, or you can use that sidebar menu and you can use this actions thing or to add whatever. So plenty of ways to do something. Well, I hope this video was useful, and let me know in the comments if you have any questions. Like it, subscribe to my channel if you want, and also check out my community, MediaMakers.club. It's a membership. You can join there and we discuss all these things in there. We do free live webinars, Q&A sessions, and you have a lot of courses in there. So check it out. The link is in the description. Thank you again, and see you in the next one.